Hi, welcome back to Postbox CA channel. Today we are going to see the important topic called natural language processing. So very important topic for all the competitive exam. We are going to see today introduction and what is work like that. So you have to remember what is NLP, natural language processing is a technique where we can say simply it's a subfield of computer science, artificial intelligence and so on. So here is NLP is a one where it's an intermediate between the you and the computer. Suppose I'm a user, I can communicate with the internet, the of internet, I can communicate with the system or mobile, what I'm there. If internet is there, I can go and search any information. So how human can communicate with each other, that answer where we can get means with the help of NLP only. Then we can say, and also moreover, the computer should duplicate the same thing. Whatever the information you are searching, suppose online or whatever there, it should be pakka and useful. Then what are the applications of NLP? One is called speech recognition and another one is called sentimental analysis, another one called the machine translation, another one is the chart parts. Many is there. So speech recognition, you can say example today Apple to support the application called Siri. So what are the use of Siri? You can talk in any language, it will be interpreted and communicate and translated to the machine language, and at last you will get the answer. Suppose I am asking what is the weather of today in English or Telugu or whatever there, it will give the answer immediately within a few seconds. Then sentimental analysis. So what are the information? Best example you can say the social media. So Facebook, Twitter, most of them today following the concept of sentimental analysis. So what is the trend of, suppose if you take election database, what is the trend? Which party have a huge vote or which party will win or what like that? All information analysis with help of method called sentimental analysis. Next one called machine translation, very important. So I am the user, I don't know about the machine language anything. I don't know Hindi, but I want to translate to what are the information Hindi to my mother language. I can use the help of computers or mobile. So that time you can use the machine translator, and what will happen? Suppose the Hindi is there, you can copy paste into the Google and it will immediately translate to the your home language, which language you are comfortable like that. That is possible. Even Chinese also, what are the languages from Chinese to English you can convert within a fraction of seconds with the help of machine translation. Next very important, chart parts. So chart parts is the one where you can understand the help of this diagram, where you have input and output, where speech recognition will be there, this is always automatic, and the NLU will be there, that is natural language understanding, another also natural language generation, at last output. So here chart parts is like a completely machine oriented one. Suppose I am searching what is the rate of the dress or something, it will give immediately the information. The information should be valid for the user. Or else I am new to the some of the private bank, I am asking about the savings scheme anything, it will immediately report, and also it will be understandable. And also it will be attractive and meaningful. Then we come to the NLU. What is NLU? It always do what do the users say. And some of the challenges in the NLU, that is called lexical and ambiguity, synthetic ambiguity, semantic ambiguity, pragmatic ambiguity. Lexical ambiguity, you can say the computer generally there are lot of things behind the computer we don't know, but in the computer can understand. Suppose I'm writing tank, the information writing here, sentence tank was full of water. Tank means water, that is a water tank, multiple meaning will be there, or else an army tank or water will be there, it should be understand. So that will help, that will be solved with the help of synthetic ambiguity. Then you can say old man and woman take the same place, like that example is there. We can't say properly the like synthetic ambiguity. So the computer can't understand what you are to convey here. Old man and woman. So if you give again old woman, it will can understand easily. Otherwise not possible. So lot of channels begin to NLU. The what kind of user, what the user want and what kind of information they want and how they want to communicate with real time and so on. Everything followed with the help of NLU unit. Then we come to the energy. It's a very important where you can say natural language generation. Here we get the answer, what should we say to the user? And it should be, what that means, it should be intelligent and conversational. At last we can say structural data as well as text and sentence planning. So the energy, you can example of, so for example, I want to know what is the weather report of next week. So that time what happened, I can, in the Google search I can give, what it will approximately say 28 Celsius or something. Like that we will get all information. So at speech recognition, you can say real time in the mobile I can speak, I can say the listening, the Google listen, hi. I can type, if I say for example in the Google recognition, I am saying example, hi, electric scooter, it recognizes immediately, it print all the information about the electric scooter immediately, whether it is in English, Japan or whatever. So here now what is NLP, is a subfield of AI and computer science, it always communicate between the computer and the user. Whether you have idea about knowledge, good knowledge about computer, technical knowledge or not, everything. So NLP is a very important area. So a lot of concepts today developed with the help of machine translation and machine learning and so on. These are about the NLP. Please kindly support our channel. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you.